God tells about going back to school and not being returning to school. Next week, and it's also about rats, since we have around 15 baby rats, which is still not sure because we miscounted and double counted many times. So, yes.
I'm pretty sure the count is 15.
Yeah.
Yes, this is the back to school episode. This is the end of summer. I don't want to say it, but I have felt a little bit of a chill in the air on some mornings. This week has been a little bit rainy, but it's still actually been pretty warm here in Seattle. We're enjoying one of the most unseasonably warm. If you're going to be in the hot seat, then you're going to have to put the records too. Will you put this on the first? Yeah. It has been an unseasonably warm summer, beautiful sunny summer. As we go into fall, I hope it continues. So you are going back to school next week. You're going to the fourth grade. Are you excited?
Yeah.
Excited to see your friends. Excited to learn new things, see your teachers. You're one of the older kids now. That's exciting. This summer you spent in a couple places. You spent at a camp. I don't want to mention the school's name. You did some zoo camps too, which I can mention. Zoo's a pretty big institution. Did you have a good time there at the zoo camps?
Yeah.
Do you want to tell us a little bit about that?
Tell us. One of the elephants kept throwing rocks at a bus since the bus used to go by the zoo, because every time it would honk, an elephant didn't like that. I think it was bamboo. She'd throw the rocks at the bus. She kept missing and kept missing. And so they took the rocks out of the exhibit. But it turned out that the two other elephants kept sneaking the rocks. And they kept asking the bus routes to stop. And they're like, no, we need to stop. And they're like, well, can you stop honking? And they were like, well, we need to let the passengers know. And one day they just hit the bus and the bus never came there.
I had heard a story about a gorilla who escaped from a zoo by climbing onto another gorilla's back. So animals are helping each other out. For those who are local here in Seattle, you may remember the Seattle Times did a series of articles called Glamour Beasts about the treatment of the elephants here at the zoo.
Woodland Park Zoo,
which resulted in a study. The study was conducted by a six-member panel chaired by a man named Brian Slinker, who is a zoo board member, veterinarian, and the dean at the Washington State University's School of Veterinary Medicine. Basically, according to the study, the elephants are being treated okay. They pointed out some things that they could be doing better, including allowing the elephants free contact with each other, replacing some of the concrete floors with sand, however, some people are criticizing the study, which has mostly been positive, which has mostly come out and said, the elephants are being treated okay, because, let's see what it says. Several local and national animal advocacy groups have raised concerns that the task force, which is heavily seated with current and former zoo board members, as well as financial supporters, may have a conflict of interest. So, take that with a grain of salt. But that was sort of this... grain of salt is just a saying. It means, here, will you turn the record? Will you put up every... Whenever I listen to the Ramones, I always want to listen to Misfits. You're wearing a Misfits shirt. And Danzig with... with Doyle.
It's at the beginning.
Oh, there it is.
Good stuff. Play something off of her CD. Behind us on the big screen is actually playing. is The Toxic Crusaders, which is a cartoon of the Toxic Avengers, New Jersey's first superhero. Did you just play the first track you're putting on Earth AD? Good. Elephants. Well, there's no more on that to say elephants. this summer, you want to talk at all? You spent some time in a wheelchair, which was interesting. You were, do you want to tell the story? Do you want me to sort of tell the backstory?
So I got sick. Unfortunately or unfortunately, which made me not be able to see the fireworks. I got really sick and I had a really hard time walking. And it was this really strange super suit. It was like some viral infection or something called HSV. Anyway. It was really weird and pretty much I took that I had to actually swallow for the first time.
It's
very interesting.
That was a big deal. But yeah, it kept getting worse and worse. All your joints swelled until you couldn't walk. And so for about 2 to 3 weeks, you were in a wheelchair. You went to camp in a wheelchair, and people were very kind and helpful to you. But that was definitely a big experience and a big part of our summer. In lighter news, we went to a soccer game recently. We saw the Sounders play the Portland Timbers. What did you think about that?
By the way, it was my first soccer game.
It was my first Major League Soccer in America game. It was my first Sounders game. We got to see the Timbers. You are from Portland. I have a 503 tattoo. However, we were rooting for the Sounders, and the Sounders won. It was a great crowd. It was actually the largest attendance as yet recorded in a Major League Soccer game. It was about 67,000 people. Did it feel like a lot of people?
Yeah.
And really, they really know how to put on a show. Can you change the record, please?
What two?
You can pick. Shout out to, while we're in between things, I'll do a commercial. Shout out to Soup Daddy on Fairview.
That was good.
Where they have delicious food and very kind people. They also do catering. Free cookies on Mondays.
Yeah. Since we didn't go there on a Monday.
We didn't.
But we still got free cookies.
We did. Again, nice people. Yeah. Oh, sorry, I interrupted you. Was that what you were gonna say?
I was gonna say that it was probably because of selective.
Don't worry about trying to. I never try and put the without a record in it. It's just gonna.
Which is like.
I'm gonna ask you to not play the first track. Not because there's anything wrong with the first track, but.
Wait.
That's fine. Can you see the lines?
Yeah, I'm trying to put it on.
Okay, the needle is right in the middle. Do you see where I've drawn? There you go. Nice. She's a lot better at it than I am. We are available for parties. DJ services. I'm going to turn it up just a little bit. But yeah, no, they definitely know how to put on a show there. There were flame pots, there was fireworks at the end. Were they both goals? Oh, okay. When they scored the goal, and then at the end, just to announce that they had won the goal. Yes, that's right. Only one goal was scored in a 90-minute game, but it was still very action-packed.
95, actually.
No, 5 minutes, yes. Sports fan here, sorry. But it was very action-packed. I felt like all the scrimmages and all the tussling over the ball. There was a fight. There was a little tension.
Yeah,
I was just going to say a great segment. Go on. That's right. That was kind of what else we've done. You saw the movie Kick-Ass, excellent parenting here. yeah, that's totally appropriate music, appropriate movie, appropriate language, appropriate no violence. So, okay, which of these two movies, and I wish I had picked out my violence. I know. Which of these two movies was scary? So there you go. We are looking forward to Kick-Ass 2, I think, which is coming out. We're looking forward to the Despicable Me 2, which
has been out. Yes, which we're probably going to see tomorrow.
Yes, maybe. We'll see this. Yes. Smurfs 2, you saw. Do you want to give a little review of that while you're here?
Well, it was good. I personally, my favorite character is
I like Azrael. I've always liked Azrael.
It was a good story. It was simple. So I think it's a little too similar to the basics of the person.
Okay.
They went to the same place, they met the same people, they
that happened from
the first.
Can you pass me the mixtape record with the guy on the cover inside the coffin? I just forgot to talk about it. And then you skip it. You'll ask, what's right in front of you? I don't think I can.
Oh, there's a coffin. I thought you were sitting in a chair.
Maybe it is a chair. Maybe it's like a throne. I think it's supposed to be a coffin. But anyway, this would be Jerry Only, the member of the Misfits who was not at Studio 7 earlier this week. Danzig and Doyle. All three can be heard on Earth AD, which we played earlier. Before that was music. Before that was. We played Tony Michael, Summertime, The Ramones. This is Paramore with, can you pass me the record? Can you figure out what's the second song in the record? Now, by Paramore off of their self-titled release, which is coming out now. Which is kind of unusual for a self-titled release.
You're gonna want to change that now.
We're talking a little bit about vinyl. We're excited that The Heist is coming out, Macklemore. I mentioned previously it's a little bit overpriced to me. Trying to pre-order it, I found including shipping and tax was $75, but I'm gonna try and figure out a way. It's limited edition and it's beautifully packaged, but I'm going to try and figure out how to get it cheaper than that. It's on gold vinyl. There is a clear vinyl edition that is out also. Lady Gaga has an album coming out, Art Pop. That might be a... Nice. You're good at that.
That might be a what?
It might be a 45, but it's not. It's at the right speed. We are excited about the new Lady Gaga coming out. We've been listening to the new Paramore. We still listen to the Riot a lot. Did you see it in there? If you want to hold it up, you can find it. We went to the Anarchist Book Fair. These are not actually books we got at the book fair. We had these books, but some of these books are books we saw at the book fair. Oh, go ahead.
Hey, there are four of
them. Yep. And they're not even the same guys. You can go ahead and try and figure that out. Who's in the band? I'll do the book fair review. Building up chicks. Dad apparently is still going strong and more people are still coming. That's what I think too. That's the same guy. I don't think this guy is either of those guys. I think he's me. We saw this and talked a little bit about this this cover. And that made me think of this book because that was really good kind of going to my word. Thank you, Nair bookstore. Need to get one. I will. I will upload that. Will you?
Welcome back.
You're watching the back to school. I'm just gonna be friends. I don't know if anyone can hear me. Can you go ahead and take it off? All right, that was our Horse and Unicorn segment in the episode. So I wanted to read. I'll get to that in a moment. You can look at it while I'm reading this, and we read this last night. So you called this out, and I think it's kind of interesting. You're watching The Beer. I'm Barbara Walters. This is Story Jones. You're actually watching a very special AM edition of Sonic the Hedgehog of the Gods. Yes, it's a late night show. We need a special air edition. Okay, can you turn it down just a little bit? Can you just keep fading it out? Just keep turning it down a little bit. Can you hold it? Yeah.
Okay, that's a fade out.
Now, can you lift the needle?
Let's see. I want some musical direction on the show.
Do you want to play the Donnas? Or
where?
Yeah, I was gonna play something. That's a good call. Speaking of vinyl, that's exactly where we were. I took off my glasses because they always get caught. It is the 20th anniversary of
Meows.
Cheshire Cat. Meows, aka Meows. For reference, here's Jawbreakers, Unfun, just for those who like 90s pop punk band, Cat, out of the covers.
Cats!
Rats! We'll get to that too. Carousel, M&M's. I kind of feel like...
You want to play?
Yeah, I looked at...
It's a cool
color. Yeah, will you play the... It's up to you. The first... Other side, please. The first track is Carousel, the second track is M&M's, and I'll leave it to you to choose which one to play. You turn and start turning it up now. You turn it up a little bit more. I do that all the time.
So, is that the cool cat that came out with the blue eyes? Those eyes are too bright for me.
Wait, say it again?
Those eyes are too bright for me to be an actual cat.
You think it's Photoshopped? Yeah, no, I'm pretty sure it is. And I think I've even seen there are cover variations where the cat's eyes are different colors. I've seen versions where they look red. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure it's Photoshopped. Alright, back to the Bible. Time for some Bible learning, Bible thumping. Then Noah began farming and planted a vineyard. He drank of the wine and became drunk and uncovered himself in a tent. So, those words are very clear. He drank of the wine and became drunk and uncovered himself in a tent. He is drunk and naked in a tent, having his three sons or spies. Ham, the father of Canaan, saw the nakedness of his father and told his two brothers outside. But Shem and Japheth took a garment and laid it upon both of their shoulders and walked backward and covered the nakedness of their father. So their neighbors, they're just covered it up. They're also walking backwards for some reason I don't quite understand. So that they don't have to look. But yeah, basically they're, ha ha ha, don't look, cover dad up, everything's okay. However, when Noah woke from his wine, he knew that what his youngest son had done to him. His youngest son, who basically just got his brothers because he was concerned. Hey, Dad's drunk and acting crazy naked in the room. Now, his youngest son is Ham. Hanan is Ham's son. So what is his reaction to his son helping him out when he got too drunk? Curse the Hanan. He curses his grandchild. That's the logical reaction. A servant of servants he shall be to his brothers. He also said, blessed be the Lord, the God of Shem. Let Hanan be his servant. May God enlarge your path and let him dwell. Can you turn that off? Let him dwell in the tents of Shem. And let Canaan be his servant. Noah lived 350 years after the flood. So all the days of Noah were 950 years. And he died. So, I mean, we're in Genesis. That's Genesis 9:26. I mean, it's where 9:20 is where we're starting there. People read this? I don't know. I'm not sure. Will you take the camera and go get some footage of the baby rats?
Sure, will you come with me?
Yes.
I think I'm stuck. No, I'm not. Please don't go, Molly.
Say it again?
Oh, please don't go, Molly. She kind of scooted backwards. Molly, there's a baby over there. Molly, there's a baby over there. Oh, never mind. She's leaving anyway.
Okay.
All right, so this rat is a free rat. We're not going to take your babies. We just prefer if you... What are you doing? Are you trying to clean your babies with a baby? All right, I think that will be enough for now. Ow.
All right, you want this seat back?
Yeah, you can have it back.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I'm just going to show some Toxic Crusaders comics. You're taking those out. We are watching the Toxic Crusaders cartoon, New Jersey's first superhero. This is the Back to School issue episode. And I was going to show my own yearbook.
Can I see?
That's not it, but yeah.
Oh, your own yearbook, like from when you were a kid.
From when I was a kid, yeah. Can you hold that for 1 second? Can you hold it, please? Hold the camera. Okay. Alright, that's me when I was in 8th grade.
I am proud that I am giving the finger in my yearbook picture. Sorry, still proud of that. Never got embarrassed, never got caught.
Wait, what?
This guy...
Let me see.
I'm awful. I know, I'm a terrible person. That's Sasha Scatter. For anyone who cares, from Choking Victim. In fact,
wait, from a band, you know?
Yeah. Thank you. From this band, Choking Victim, which later became Leftover Crack and Star Fucking Hipsters. Language. There are children watching. Jeez.
Whatever. On it.
Uh huh. Great, because this song's called Fuck America. This is Sasha's book, published under his real name, Sasha Dizwell, Carnival of Chaos, which was about his tour with the Nomadic Festival, which was a sort of carnival, circus burlesque type, traveling, punk, squatter, craziness that occurred. It's a good book. No, it's a good book. It turns up in anarcho bookstores and punk history sections.
This was,
What was?
What did I just make?
Oh, yeah. Do you want to make one? Talk about Eat Club Rats. Eat Club Rats is the business that we've run together since 2010, a father and daughter run business.
They don't know about it?
I mentioned it from time to time, but I don't assume they is the same people every time, you know?
Oh!
Yeah. Right now, I guess being a rattery is the biggest sort of thing from our business.
We have
15 rats. They'll be available in the middle of October. Two of them have already been claimed, and we're going to keep some for ourselves, but...
no two particular ones yet.
Right. If you're interested and if you're in the Seattle area, get in touch, because those rats are available.
And you saw how cute they were.
They're super cute. It looks like a lot of them are going to be hooded rats. And we have, they are third generation rats here at eClove. Their grandfather Starbuck is still with us. Their grandmother Nico has passed on, but many of her sons and daughters are still around. And Molly came from, do you remember, is it called Animal Talk?
Yeah, I think so.
The Animal Talk shelter, actually.
No kill shelter.
Right, a no kill animal shelter. I'm confused as to the business model.
I think they're half
shelter.
And half
shelter, yes, I agree. Grandma was from Petco, Grandpa was from PetSmart. Tonight's our third generation equal of rats. It will be available coming up shortly in about 6 weeks. We also provide rat boarding. Right, we're coming up with our own line of rat suits. We provide rat consultation services. Consultation, we consult with someone to give them ideas. You can do excellent designing rat play spaces. I'm taking time to help you design rat play spaces that are all natural materials and safe. Recycled materials, cardboard, and things like that. I made it sound fancy in English, but it's what you do with all the apps.
I didn't know that.
want to do something like that. Rat boarding, we have provided that service. If you want to do the rat, a small pet, which has to be a I'm not really big to that kind of thing.
Oh, yeah, we do. We do have to do the rat.
Can you sit there? Can I?
Okay.
Yeah.
What?
I said you're not really interested in the music anymore. I'm stepping over you.
You could have told me.
I did tell you.
Okay.
When I said, can I sit here? That would be telling you.
No, but I mean, like, you could have told me to switch.
Oh. I'm sorry. No, I didn't mean to make it sound like you were negligent and not switching the record. I just meant, it looks like you're doing that. I'd like to move on with the record. I'd actually like to play a bunch of things real fast. Record players and the ability to switch between records and DJ like that.
You know, this is really songs and stuff, and it's mixed in it.
Uh-huh.
Except she herself, I'm not sure if she's famous, because I've never
heard of her. Wait, who is she? Khalees. She's famous enough. No, she's in, yeah, you're right, though. It's, the song is more famous than her. It's been remixed a lot, or, yeah. Whatever name the song I want to play, it's called Keep It Down.
Of exciting news for them, for when you get back to school. You've had quite a full summer. This is Don't Wait Up For Me by the Donnas. I'm incredibly pretty purple vinyl.
Whoa,
marble purple vinyl. Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Segue away from the song. I don't have the attention span for a guitar solo.
What?
I don't have the attention span for a guitar solo. Should we play I Wanna Rock? This is Twisted Sister. We're not gonna take it.
We're not gonna take it.
Yeah. I guess, yeah, stick with the classics.
Song lyrics? Or,
yeah.
Yeah, cool.
That sounds really cool. Is it finished?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you want to do a portion?
Yes.
Or you have
to listen
to
music.
Tell
yes.
Okay. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Okay, can you hold it down a little bit? Okay. 25.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25.
Did I say 89? Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
No, I'm just going to do 5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Ooh, 78 or 2. I'm going to have to say 2.
Okay. Do you ever feel like a plastic bag just into the wind? You got taken!
Hey, yeah.
Right on.
Right on.
Disaster strikes your set.
I just, like, turned away from it.
That actually happens just the other day.
Yeah.
You have been, and then more recently you haven't been, and I talk.
I'm discussing it with you.
I probably should be discussing it with other responsible adults and getting their opinion. I don't know about showing you on the internet, having you, I feel like people, it's really easy for children to get exploited on the internet. I was linked to some videos by, what are they called, Bratley or something like that, but it made me think of Codeus and just sort of children being loud and in the camera, and it looked like they were getting lots of views, just like Codeus, who is this... Codeus is this boy that is sort of loud on the internet. He screams into the camera and stuff and is weird, which is fine if it's really his own, whatever, however old he is, not much older than you, sense of humor. A lot of people say it's his parents who are sort of exploiting him and pushing him into doing those things, and especially making money off it. This channel makes no money.
Yeah, you can tell, since you don't have to pay to watch YouTube.
Yeah, but no one has to pay to watch YouTube. On YouTube, people, this channel makes no money because we don't get any advertising. No one would have to pay to watch it either way. but we don't collect advertising revenue, and I don't feel like I feel like I want to include you. I'm not pushing or exploiting. And then there's just the basic security issue of just having you out there. Your face out there. But thank you as much as I think you are aware, and I think you are cautious. this is Katy Perry. You want to show something in your blog comments? Go for it.
Well, yeah. Usually they only sell the thick comic books. What are those called? I we kept doing it at my
house. Graphic novels?
Yeah, graphic novels. Usually they only sold graphic novels, but these are from a long time ago, as if you were growing up, you may remember.
Here's
Anyway, 38. Anyway, we went to a comic book store called
Xanadu
Comics,
which is a comic store. Shout out to
Xanadu,
yeah, thank you for that.
Yeah, and they still had these.
Should we talk about Warriors? Do you want to talk about Adventure Time?
Sure, yeah.
I don't think you play too much. I think you're a gamer. You've been a gamer for a long time, but this game in particular has really captured your attention. In Minecraft, you kind of make your own games, which I think is really
neat. Yeah, I
think
it's
really
Minecraft. Pretty much, it's sometimes a computer game, except I mostly play on Pocket Edition, which is on my phone. I got into it by my cousin,
Thank you.
one's gonna fade out, but we're already almost at the end of the song, so we're gonna do it. Last time I played this song, the episode ended with me dancing on my butt. Smash Up. This is Corn on Macabre. Off Corn on Macabre 2. What am I playing? I don't have my energy to. Shall I play I'm Okay, you're Okay, I'm Undead, or Specially Made Sunglasses?
Specially
Made Sunglasses. Yeah, I have a feeling that's going to be good too.
Mitch Clem cover art. Again, a pretty vinyl. Let's see, off of their head side. Here's the Lemuria side. With, is it only one song, right? It's What's It Fell. Lemuria is playing at Bogart's, which is a club that's now being promoted by the guy who used to, the former owner of the Funhouse, who's now booking shows at Bogart's in Soto. I don't know too much, I haven't been there yet. Including Lemuria, who's playing soon-ish.
Thank you.
tell which is the front and the back of this record. I'm a reviver. There's Alex Bell, Eiffel.
Special bonus finish, for sure. Here's Starbuck, Granddaddy Starbuck. What are you doing, sir? Sneezy. Woozy.
Woozy Wazzles, Weezy.
Woozy Wazzles. Woozy
Wazzles. Should I let him run around?
Sure. And that's it.
And carefully put you down.
Okay,
there you go.
Random foot injury on the show, and Statler just crawled around.